Antarctica, the seventh and the most remote continent of them all. Wild and wonderful, with unique sights and experiences. From Ushuaia through the notorious Drake Passage to the unforgettable White Continent itself. Join us for the ultimate guide about what it's actually like on board Quark Expedition's magnificent ultramarine ship. And into the vastness that is Antarctica. Today is the day. I'd spent a week in Buenos Aires, Montevideo, and Punta del Este. But it was time to leave those sunny, sultry backdrops behind and head south to our port of departure, Ushuaia.
Gracias.
And after a quick walk around the city at the end of the world, it was straight to our home for the next 9 nights, Ultramarine.
Here we go, the Ultramarine.
Hi, how are you?
Good, yeah, mate. All good.
Great to be aboard.
Thank you.
Yeah, how are you doing? You well? Where are your passports?
Let me welcome you aboard, my digs. And how's about this for a great start? I booked a twin share, got a double, all to myself.
Next 10 days or so here on Quark's Ultramarine balcony suite with my own private view of right now the Beagle Channel in Ushuaia, but all the way to Antarctica. Two full days travel across the Drake Passage. What to do? Well, on Ultramarine, they're getting you ready. They're building that anticipation and bringing you deep into the history, the wildlife, and the landscape of Antarctica. From the evening of day one through day two, the Ambassador Theatre was the hub of our activity. Meeting the crew at the captain's drink reception.
Keeping the secret, so if you want to see and you want to hear where are we going, you should better pass by the bridge. And the
safety briefings.
Extra tasks.
Or excursion groups on the Ultramarine when we have helicopters in addition to our Zodiacs.
And getting us ready for the wildlife we're about to see.
And that's not just limited to whales, you can do that with any size creature from tiny crabs and shrimp to these large and wonderful creatures.
And on a crossing which is, in maritime terms, considered rough, but in Drake Passage terms, considered pretty moderate, getting to find our sea legs just a little bit. We're brought around the ready rooms from where we'll be going on our Zodiac outings. And if the captain invites you to the bridge, it would seem rude not to take him up on the offer. And it's also a time when you're making friendships with fellow passengers, and we'll be hearing a lot more from this amazing group later. But this is all just the warm-up. Tomorrow, it's the main event.
It's day three. Today's the day we reach Antarctica, but I'm not a maritime expert, so it tells me we are moving a little bit more slowly because it's foggy out there. Fog, cold waters, icebergs. Nothing ever went wrong in shipping before with that.
With anticipation growing right across the ship, we were kept busy, brought up to the helideck for a safety briefing ahead of what we hoped for, a possible flight later in the week. And then in early afternoon, the reality of where we were and where we were headed for became ever more apparent.
Further south we go, further into the 60s in latitude. It's more like Antarctica, it's more like winter. It's actually snowing, we're in Antarctica. Icebergs, right ahead.
And then the wildlife started to show up.
And here we finally are, land in Antarctica. Deception Island. After icebergs galore, after a lot of open water, we're here. Now that we're here, now that we're in Antarctica, huge excitement, everybody's got the camera gear out, park is ready to run. At any moment, if people spot something out the window, fabulous. We are in the seventh continent.
Every day here seems to bring it to the next level. Getting on board, the crossing, reaching Antarctica, and now today, like these guys, we're getting on the water.
Oh! And they're going dancing and racing.
And is it possible to get fed up of seeing this kind of thing? I don't think so. And all before breakfast too. So for our first steps off the ship since Ushuaia, it's paddleboarding in the Antarctic.
Paddleboarding in Antarctica.
Yes.
Anything better to do? Paddling today. Just amazing. Those are my feet. This is where I am. I'm trying to ease off on the superlatives, but it's very, very difficult. Hear that? We hear that all the time. Maybe desolate, but there's movement all around. There's the penguins.
Look at these guys. Joining us for the paddle.
See, this is one of the amazing things about paddling. You will never feel this close in a zodiac.
Personally, I'd had enough exercise, but not for Constantine.
As many as you like.
One of the great things about the trip on Ultramarine was that a morning like this, where we were paddleboarding and other people were zodiacing, you might think, am I missing out? No, they bring you for the zodiac trip then, post the activity. And then we heard something crash behind us and turned to see this iceberg in the middle start to fall apart.
Is that correct, Amor? Oh my god, here we go!
Oh!
Is it going to go?
Wow.
Is it all going?
Yep.
And speeding this up a bit shows you exactly what we're talking about. All this and it's not even lunchtime. I didn't get near enough footage of the restaurant. Too busy eating, I suppose. While we eat, the ship moves on to its next destination, and this time we're setting foot on the continent.
I'm here on land in the seventh continent, Antarctica, this way to the South Pole. How are we doing back there?
So good!
Much as this is a tourist trail, there are hazards. We're being sent around because all things being equal, Quark don't want to lose us in that crevasse. Is that right, Tim?
Right. It's a jungle out there.
Woo! The rain disappears in 6 minutes.
We have made it to the summit, where no person, apart from maybe them, have ever been before. Expedition extraordinaire.
If kayaking is your thing, you can do it every day on Ultramarine instead of the Zodiac trips, like these guys.
Well, those seals, like a nice little sleep in front of us here. As well as the activities. We're brought around by our guides on zodiacs to see wildlife, landscape, like amazing icebergs like this one.
That evening on our return to Ultramarine, the uncertainty that is at the heart of every trip to Antarctica became clear. A crew member had taken seriously ill and the ship would have to divert its course to arrange for a medical evacuation. We were staying in the Antarctic, we were heading back north.
Very unusual to come across other ships, believe it or not, when you're down in Antarctica, notwithstanding how many that there actually are. Because we've had to change our schedule because of a medical emergency for a crew member, we have now actually come across one here at Penguin Island.
The goal was to hit a weather window late that afternoon at King George's Island to arrange for the medical evacuation from an airstrip. In the meantime, the crew brought us to Penguin Island, nearly snow-free on the surface, a dormant volcano, where we headed out again on Zodiacs. You can really hear that crackle now. In fact, you could say they're called
Ice Krispies.
And speaking of ice,
but as the ice keeps getting compressed, you get more snowfall, just like you're seeing now build up on this ice. The weight just compresses everything out of it, and you're left with this super clear stuff on the bottom. One of my glaciology friends told me that something like this might be in the ballpark of anywhere from 1500 to 10,000 years old in this area.
My precious.
Coming ashore here on Penguin Island, and the penguins have made a welcoming party to greet us, and they keep coming towards us. We don't approach them. We got penguins right here. They're kind of curious about us.
Why they call it Penguin Island? No idea. It wasn't just penguins on Penguin Island. Back on the ship, in the afternoon, we moved from Penguin Island to King George Island to be in place for the plane coming from Chile for the medical evacuation. We had this visit from a friendly skua, but then in early evening, word came through the evacuation had been a success, the crew member being safely transported to Ushuaia, and we were about to resume our journey south.
Morning from the deck of the Ultramarine. It's about 5:30 in the morning, Wednesday, 10th January. I don't know what day of the trip this is. Beautiful blue sky behind. Hopefully that's something that's clearing, because right ahead, a bit foggy at the moment. We're moving quite slowly. But if we get a day that looks a little bit more like this, I think we'll be out kayaking. I think we're doing quite a lot today in a place called Mickelson Harbour.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning. The time is 7 a.m. on Wednesday, January 10th. And during the night, Ultramarine sail into the sunset and across the Bransfield Strait toward Trinity Island and Mickelson. Tropical Sound Harbor. Our current position is 63 degrees 46 minutes south, 60 degrees 25 minutes west.
This is cool.
Hey, birdies. How are you guys?
These are the chin straps. They've got that white sort of...
Oh, dear. I thought I fell hard.
These guys are funny. They always kind of play follow the leader like this. They're safety and numbers oriented.
Yeah.
Do
come up now.
Okay, do that. That was more comfortable.
You in shot?
I think so.
Emperor penguin. And they're sort of a special story in and of themselves. We won't see any emperors down here in the peninsula region. They live in other, much icier areas of Antarctica.
And after that kayak trip, we're now going ashore, see more of the concert.
This, for fairly clear reasons, is what they call a penguin highway. Shipwrecks, whale bones, penguin colonies, and the most stunning backdrops imaginable. Unbelievable. Back on board, here are some of the other facilities we have available.
We've got a library.
We have a gym. Only 797 miles to go. South Georgia.
We have a spa. Maybe not. We have a sauna.
Sir, put your cloth bag on.
Get the clothes back on, sir.
We have a lounge where we, well, a lounge. We have a sort of a walking track. 13 times around the deck, maybe 12. Get to 3K. We've got a 24-hour coffee dock.
We have a fabulous boutique where we spend a lot of time and quite a bit of money on Antarctic merchandise with the lovely Anna from Ukraine at the helm.
Very missing you here. Hello.
And before we started the afternoon zodiac trip through spectacular iceberg fields, we got word that the infamous polar plunge was coming up on our return.
Thank you.
good look back.
So this attire is because we are here waiting to go.
We're ready.
Right past and down here, and you may or may not be able to see, but there are people jumping off the ship into the Antarctic water, and that will be us any moment now. We've had a sauna to prepare. How was the sauna, everyone?
Maybe.
Yeah.
There was a naked man in there. It was rather shocking.
It was. Security intervened. And now we're getting set. So, coming soon. Video this, but here's the build up. You got a shot afterwards. It's a stunning morning in Charco Bay, and we are going up in the helicopter into this. In the waiting room for the helicopter flight seeing, exciting news, I'm the co-pilot. Nothing to worry about.
this most perfect of blue sky Antarctic days, it was one last trip on the Zodiac, causing great excitement for some in the ready room. And maybe you're a penguin person, but if you're a whale person, they kept the best for last, as two humpbacks got up close. That's worth seeing again from a different angle.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, you okay?
As is Melinda's fall.
Okay, you okay?
And from the top of the food chain to the bottom, meet the krill.
This is it. This is the last spin, the last Zodiac in Antarctica. It's coming to an end.
Yeah, it's a bit slow.
Don't want it to end. I know.
No one wants it to end. We're in heaven.
Say yes to heaven. Say yes to me. Say yes to heaven. Say yes to me. If you go, I'll stay. You come back, I'll be right here. Like a barge at sea. In the storm I'll stay clear, 'cause I got my mind on you. I got my mind on you.
Last day in Antarctica, we're up to the heli deck for a toast to say goodbye.
I'm gonna do a half a toast for the krill. Thank you, Sylvia, for bringing the krill along. Lily caught the krill. Thanks, Lily. You're killing it. And the final toast, I would like to toast to Antarctica itself, this very, very wild and special place. Your mindset and your drive to come here, it is another planet. I'm so thankful that you've all chosen to come on this voyage in particular. And I would like to say the final toast to Antarctica itself. Cheers to this beautiful continent.
Cheers! Here's to Antarctica! Woo!
This was not to be the last dancing of the day, but what did change was the weather as soon as we went out into the drake.
We're
coping skills for a rocky Drake Passage crossing? Dance against the tilt. Day 8 was about three things: getting used to 4.5 meter plus swells as we crossed the Drake Passage.
Yeah.
Back to the Ambassador Theatre, including a talk about future Quark trips, and Boogie Bingo.
Just a sweetie morning, born and raised in South Detroit. Took the midnight train, go in anywhere.
Including a free twerking lesson from expedition team member John.
Down motion, it's not up motion.
Yeah,
you gotta
get way forward.
Like,
On day 9, the further we travelled, the calmer the sea became. There was also still time to learn a little bit more about history in the Ambassador Theatre.
There is always another one walking beside you.
So we've almost made it through the Drake, and now, 9 days after leaving it behind, land ahoy, being challenged.
There were big bids at the big charity auction? No, not from us.
35. Before we slow it down a little, let's take it one last leap. Do I have 37.50? We're at 61, and we're going twice. Last chance, folks. All right, and we are sold out. Whoa!
And a chance to say goodbye and thank you to an amazing crew.
Thanks to the entire expedition team for all of the hard work each and every day of this voyage. To make it all possible. Is that your mom calling? I'll talk to her. But huge thanks to these people. They are extremely talented, extremely passionate about these regions. Be a big day tomorrow, as we all know. Thank you in advance for that, and thank you for this entire trip.
And then you wake up and that's it. It's all over. Back in Ushuaia after an extraordinary voyage. In lots of ways, extraordinary what we saw and what we did, but extraordinary in some of the challenges that were faced along the way by the crew, by the team. Illnesses, diversions, watching storms. It's all part of the great Antarctic experience. What to say? What an incredible time. I mean, you know what you're signing up for in ways. You know what you're signing up for. The most incredible.
Yep, that's when the camera decided to stop recording audio. At the moment of emotion at the end of the trip, what I wanted to tell you was, when you go to the Antarctic,
You're going to get magnificent scenery. You're going to get incredible wildlife. What I can't guarantee you, and what I was lucky enough to get, was the abiding memory of laughter from this great group, our penguin colony, as we called ourselves. Cheers! Sip.
You can't say zip.
That's true. I can edit that bit out. Welcome to table fun.
We're just doing what he tells us to. We haven't officially signed any waivers yet.
No.
We don't know where this is going.
Yeah, do you want to do it again? I won't say sip.
Yeah, don't say sip. You all know it.
Yeah, okay. Everyone knows.
Okay. We'll just be
and let's not even do 3, 2, 1. Just like, you know.
We'll just be silent and do it.
Cheers!
I didn't say shoot.
Okay, do it again. Okay.
Again, guys.
Hang on a second. Okay.
You got people talking on Twitter.
4 solo travelers from Ireland, England, Colorado, and Minnesota, and 2 friends from Texas that were the absolute heartbeat of this trip.
Steep and awkward. Jesus. Content, my friends.
The brilliant expedition team and our fellow passengers on board were a huge part of the experience too. We weren't quite done yet. A bus tour of Tierra del Fuego National Park preceded the charter flight home and back to Buenos Aires Airport. If you've ever thought about going to Antarctica, do it. Get planning and do it. I guarantee you the most amazing experience, and I wish you the good fortune of great friends too.
He's lost here.
No, up and down.
Barry, you know I'm the serious one.